rubbish. You're rubbish.
You're a waste of space.
Can you go away, please?
That's good, Lauren. That's good. But can you try and make it a bit stronger for me? Sit up, look at him.
Tell him to go away, okay?
Okay.
Avatar therapy is for people who hear distressing auditory hallucinations or voices. So these are mainly people who have diagnoses of schizophrenia and related conditions. A computer system is used to create a face representing the entity that the person usually believes is behind their voices and a copy of the voice they hear. And the software is remarkable in that it can produce a complete range of voices, voice transforms, so that we get a very high match of what the person experiences to what they see on the computer.
Whenever his friends asked him if he would like to go out with them, he would only answer, "I don't know." He wouldn't say yes, and he wouldn't say no either.
So the therapy is delivered over 6 sessions, each of about 10 minutes long, where the person is having a dialogue with their avatar. And gradually the avatar changes in response to the person standing up to it. So as the person says, "I'm tired of hearing this, leave me alone," the avatar gradually concedes. The whole experience changes from something that's very frightening to something that's much more in the person's control.
Tell him you don't want to hear this rubbish anymore when he comes in with his usual statements.
How come you're so confident?
Because I'm not going to listen to you anymore.
So the first pilot study of avatar therapy was just a very small number of patients, and it was remarkably successful. We needed to do a larger randomized control trial where we compared avatar therapy to an alternative psychological intervention. There were 150 people in the trial, 75 got avatar therapy, 75 got the alternative therapy. In the avatar therapy, we had about 9 people who completely stopped hearing their voices, and by 3 months, really large and significant decreases in the amount of distress people felt in relation to their voices, the number of times a day they heard the voices, and the extent to which they felt overpowered by the voice, where they found the voice was omnipotent or malevolent and threatening. So that all decreased as well. So globally, a very impressive result at 3 months. So the real advance that comes from avatar therapy is the improvement in treatment. So antipsychotic medication is helpful to a point, but many people who have been on antipsychotic medication for years and years still have their voices. Similarly, psychological therapies added on to antipsychotics medication also leave many people still with chronic persisting voices that are horrible and distressing. And our study that's published in The Lancet tackled that group, people who had been stuck with their voices for at least a year, despite having the best treatment that could be thrown at them currently, and yet we still get an improvement. We're still getting a significant benefit from avatar therapy on top of standard treatments. And so I think it's a real advance, and I think there will come a time when this will be part of routine provision of psychological treatments for voice hearers in psychosis.